Hi there, I welcome you to my channel, The Chemist Chemistry. If today happens to be your first time of coming across any of my video, I'd like you to watch it to an end. Don't forget to also tell us your mind in the comment section. Below the video, also I have links to some of our previous video lessons there. You can click on the link and watch them to enlighten your understanding in chemistry as a course. Now, in today's video lesson, we'll be talking about importance of Bohr's atomic structure. After I taught Bohr's atomic model, a student asked a question about how important Bohr's atomic structure or model is, and that is the reason for which I want to make this video, or I decided to make this video. So let's proceed. So this is a picture of Niels Bohr in the first video lesson that was talking about his atomic structure. This same picture was there to just give you a mental idea or a picture of who Bohr was. Now, we also learned in that video lesson that the vapor of an element glow. In other words, what we are trying to say is that anytime that an electric charge or anytime that an element gains much energy, when an element is heated or gain much energy, now something happened to the element. Now what happened to the element is that it begins to glow, and whenever that happened, the vapor of that element is what glowed. I want you to take note of that. Yes. Now the same thing happened also when that element, an atom of that element, is in a compound. I want you to take note of that. When you know that atoms come together to form a molecule, let's say a compound. Very good. So even in a compound or in a molecule, that same thing happened. Now we are saying a typical example of that, or we learned that a typical example of that is when white light, specifically we use the ultraviolet radiation from the sun as an example, that when it separates into its constituent colors, okay, we made mention on the fact that we will get the colors that came together to form that white light, and we use the rainbow as an example, that rainbow color, or the separation of, or the splitting of the white light that is from the ultraviolet radiation from the sun into the colors of the rainbow, that those seven colors, is a typical example of what is termed as emission spectra. And under that, we talk about continuous and line spectra or spectrum. And we made mention of the fact that that of the rainbow formation is an example of continuous spectrum. I want you to take note of that. If you haven't watched that video, I have the link below this. You can click on it and then you go and watch it. So I want you to have it in mind that anytime that an element, whether in a compound for or in its elemental state, is heated or gain much energy, or when electric current is passed through, something happened. What happened to the element is that it begins to glow. Yes, it vapor, it begins to glow. And under cathode ray tube experiment, or the discharge tube experiment by J.J. Thomson, I gave a picture to explain what we mean by the glow. So we have that video link also below. You can click on it and watch it. All right. So now, the importance of Bohr's model of the atom is that, one, the Bohr's model of the atom was able to explain the stability of the atom. In other words, we realized from Bohr's model that Bohr said that the electrons revolve, or they orbit around the nucleus of the atom in a stationary state. We learned that. Yes, so Bohr's model aided us to know that to explain how stable the atom is, to the extent that it's not that maybe the atom, by letting us know that for the atom, we have the electrons in a stationary state, they are just orbiting around the nucleus of the atom, and then we have the protons and the neutrons also within the nucleus of the atom. Now, the second point is that Bohr's model of the atom explained the phenomenon of atomic spectra. So I just made mention of the fact that we learn from emission spectra that we have the continuous and the line spectrum, and that came about as a result of the fact that anytime that an element or an element either in its elemental form or in a compound form gained much energy, it begin to emit vapor, and that vapor will glow very good. So that birth what is termed as the atomic spectra, and I made mention of the fact that we have the line and the continuous spectrum in that video lesson. Also, the third point is that Bohr's model of the atom explained the ionization of gases. Now, one thing that I want you to take note of, which we will be tackling very soon under periodic chemistry or periodicity, we are going to learn about ionization energy as one of the periodic variations. And when we talk about ionization energy, it is the minimum amount of energy release or required to remove one mole of an electron from an atom for that atom to form an isolated gaseous cation. And before the ionization will take place, the atom must exist in the gaseous phase or state. I want you to take note of that. So we have learned already that the atom or the element will gain energy or in the form of heat. That is heat energy. Heat is a form of energy. Very good. And when it gains that energy, then that is when it will be able to release or remove an electron. Very good. So what I want you to take note here is that Bohr's model of the atom explained the ionization of gases by making us know that indeed an atom can indeed move an electron or can donate an electron. In other words, an electron can move from either a higher energy level to a lower energy level, or from a lower energy level to a higher energy level. And in that video lesson, I made mention of the fact that when an atom moves from a higher energy level to a lower energy level, we call it de-excitation. And when it moves from a lower energy level to a higher energy level, we term it as excitation energy. Very good. So below this video lesson, I have the link to that particular lesson. You can click on it and watch it if you haven't watched it, and you will get a further understanding and explanation from that particular video lesson. So this will bring us to the end of this lesson. So we have three main important that I've mentioned in this video lesson. We do have other important, but this is just the three that I've mentioned in this video lesson to enable you to know that indeed Bohr's model or Bohr's structure of the atom have an important. This is the end of the video lesson. Please don't forget to destroy the subscribing button, click on the notification bell, and share this video lesson to others to enrich their scope in chemistry. And don't forget to tell us your mind in the comment section. And lastly, there's another link. You can click on it. It's a WhatsApp link. It will direct you to me, and you can ask any question. If you want me to create video content for your channel or anything, just click on that WhatsApp link. It will direct you personally to me. We can chat. And also, we have a Facebook page, a newly created Facebook platform. You can click on the link below. We have a link to that also below. Click on it and then join that Facebook page. God bless you. Stay blessed for more video lessons.